low. Now my jewelry box froze. Fuck up bowl, fuck up stove. Counted millions in a cove. Bad bitch, booted swole. Got her on bankroll. Can't fold, that's a no. Headshot, case closed.
What is up, guys? It's Andy Frisella, and this is the show for the realists. Say goodbye to the lies, the fakeness, and delusions of modern society, and welcome to motherfucking reality. Guys, today we have Q and AF. This is where I bring the Qs, and you bring the... Wait, hold on. This is where you bring the Qs. Who brought the Qs?
The people.
All right. The people bring the Qs, and I give the AFs.
Yeah.
How about that?
Basically.
All right. Let's do the show. What's the show? We got a fee.
We do have a fee.
The fee is very simple. If it made you think, if it made you laugh, if it gave you some info that's going to help make you better, if it gave you a new perspective, if it taught you something, please share the show. That's what we're going for here. So, yeah. What's up, dude? Yeah, you got your trophy there.
I got my trophy.
Yeah. Dude, that's going right on the mantle. I know it is when you get home.
I mean, I think it looks good here.
It does look good there.
It does. I mean, it looks pretty good there.
Yeah.
I'd expect it to be bigger and blacker, but this works.
That was mediocre. It was a mediocre joke. All right.
Yeah. So yeah, I got three good ones for you, bro.
Yeah. So guys, if this is your first time listening, we go back and forth between content. We go with CTI, which is more current issues, what's going on. Most of people that listen to that walk away some sort of pissed off because I tell the truth. Then we have Q&AF, where I answer your entrepreneurship questions, your business questions, your get better questions, yeah, your personal development.
Life questions.
Yeah, your life, whatever, man. And we go back and forth. So that's what we're going to do today.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
And guys, if you want to submit your questions, please email them in to askandy@andyfrisella.com. And with that being said, brother, let's knock these out. Question number one for you, Andy. And if you talked about the work and the belief, right, and how the belief comes after the work, how do you handle the non-believers, whether they're in your company or in your friend group, that still don't believe in you after the proof has already come? How do you handle those guys?
I don't associate with those people.
Hmm.
They're irrelevant. I don't care.
Hmm.
Like, they're not on my radar. They don't exist in my mind. Like, when they speak, I don't hear them. When they're in my sight, I don't see them. They're invisible to me.
Yeah.
Like, it's that simple.
People put too much pressure on that.
Yeah.
Too much interest on that.
No, yeah. Dude, I don't give a fuck what someone thinks of me, dude. Bro, why would you? I don't understand the obsession of this. Like, I really don't. I really don't understand the fixation that people have on earning the approval of people that don't fucking matter. I think this holds people back more than anything. Like, you're trying to win the opinion of someone who isn't doing anything. They haven't done anything. Anybody who's done something like you're trying to do is going to look at what you've done and respect it, even if they're your competitor. All right? So why are you worried about earning the approval of these people from your past, whether they're your family or your friends or however close they are, when they haven't done anything? Like, I don't care. I don't know how else to say that. Like, I really don't. Like, it's like when people argue with me on the internet, I have to value your opinion for me to exchange in some sort of dialogue with you. Like, I'm not arguing with someone who lives in a fucking $450 apartment who is on, you know,
or the basement.
Yeah.
Or like, mom's house. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm not fucking arguing. That person's not worth my fucking time to argue with. Like, your life is your life. My life is my life. It speaks for itself. I don't care if you fucking like it. And if you don't like it, it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
It's irrelevant. And like, it's wasted energy, dude.
Why do you think people put so much interest on that then?
Because I think that people don't truly believe in themselves, and they don't truly believe that they're good. Even when the evidence is there that they've done some good things, I think that they still sell themselves short. You know, I think a lot of times people are bullied growing up. They're told they're never going to be anything. They're told they're not good enough. You know, I was told all those fucking things too. And it can be hard to overcome those things, you know? And I think that even when you do achieve big things, there's still people that you want to notice, right? But yeah, like, at the end of the day, it really doesn't matter. I think it's kind of like you go through a phase. Like in the beginning, you're just kind of working. Then you get to a certain level and you expect this person or these people to like somehow approve of you. What they're going to do is they're going to pretend like they don't see you winning, you know? So why do you care? You know, just pretend you don't see them back. It's going to bother them worse, you know? And that's just me, dude. Like I think it's wasted energy. I think people that overly concern themselves with the opinions of others limit their own success. I think that energy should be put into moving forward. I think that anybody I know that wins big does not put, I can't think of a conversation that I've ever had with like my entrepreneur successful friends, any of them. I'm trying to think back where they've ever like talked about someone from the past at all. Like they just don't care. And you have to let it go, dude. Like anytime you step outside the normal of what life is supposed to be, what people are programmed to live like, which is very sad existence, right? Like get a job, go to work, barely pay your bills, drink some beers, fucking complain about shit and do it over and over and over again and then die. And it's just not a way to live. So like, I don't respect that lifestyle. So I don't respect the opinions of people that live that lifestyle. And you shouldn't either.
Yeah. Yeah. That's fucking real.
Yeah.
That's real. Andy, question number two. Andy, you once said that if you saw if you had a business that sold people what they wanted instead of what they needed, you would have been way more successful quicker. Can you elaborate on that?
Yeah. People want ice cream. They don't want fucking protein shakes. People want alcohol. They don't want fucking healthy fucking brownies.
Yeah.
That people want fun and comfort and entertainment. They don't want to get better. It's not their nature to get better. So when you're constantly fighting against the human nature to get better, it's a harder sale, right? Everything I sell, for the most part, with the exception of being in the cannabis space or the alcohol space, all those other things that I'm in, which is most of my business, is get people better. And that is something that requires a level of education with the consumer that is not there with these other things. So there's an extra step in the process when you're selling things to improve people's lives versus selling things to pacify their desires. Mm. All right. So that's what I mean when I say that. So if I were, you know, I'm not complaining about where I'm at because I could sleep at night and I feel like I'm contributing to people and I know I'm making people better.
It's ethical. Yeah,
it's a huge deal.
Yeah.
It's a huge deal. But I think I could have been where I'm at now much faster had I been selling frozen custard or had I been selling fucking pizza or had I been selling, you know, you get what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So like, you know, I'm not complaining about where we're at. I love what we do and it's fucking amazing and it's turning into something really iconic and special. But I, you know, when you go with what people want versus what they need, it's an easier sale. It just is. Mm. The difference is though, developing customer loyalty in that scenario is much more difficult because you're not running any sort of education process.
Right.
You're not able to really teach them anything, right?
Really no investment from the customer.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So your product has to be, you know, exceptionally, exceptionally, exceptionally better than everybody else's. And a lot of these things are commodities. Like frozen custard, it's a debate whose is the best, right? Everybody's little town has their place and it's the best. Pizza's the same. You know, if you ask a dude from New York, you ask a person from St. Louis, you ask a person from California what the best pizza is, they're all going to say different shit.
Right.
So, you know, when you're in a space of education and you can explain the superior nature of your products consistently and teach your customers to actually be better, there's loyalty that can be built there where it's harder to build there. So it's the exchange of different types of businesses.
Sure.
That makes sense.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
No, that makes perfect sense.
So you know, if you're selling something that people want every day, right? Coffee.
Right.
Right?
Right.
People want coffee. It's easier to find customers to buy coffee than it is to find customers that want to lose 100 pounds. Right. Because most people that want to lose 100 pounds don't even want to lose 100 pounds. They want to go eat pizza.
Right.
They need to lose 100 pounds. Mm. And that's a different kind of conversation.
Would you say the loyalty, because like, you look at a brand like Starbucks, right? Like that's... It has an extremely loyal base. Would you equip, like, is that loyalty the same as the loyalty that you have with your customers at 1P?
No, I don't think so. I think Starbucks just does a better job on a wide scale than most of the competitors that they have. You know, when you walk into a Starbucks, it has a feel.
Mm-hmm.
It has a very distinct smell. Has yeah. a very distinct everything. Like, you know, you're in a fucking Starbucks, and it's an experience.
Yeah.
And their experience. Now, I don't drink coffee, so like, I don't want to piss anybody off who has coffee stores. Okay.
Yeah.
I'm sure there's much better coffee shops, and I'm sure they're way better. But I'm saying on a mass scale, they do it the best,
mm-hmm.
right? So that's what that's about.
Yeah, I love it.
You know, I think, you know, there's other companies that are making a lot of headway, right? Like, there's Black Rifle Coffee, who are starting to open stores and locations,
yeah.
and they're a patriotic pro-America brand. And I think the more that they open those stores, the more they're going to take a fucking bite out of Starbucks' ass.
Yeah.
Because people are tired of the woke shit.
They're getting yelled at Starbucks.
I'm fucking, listen, bro. There's plenty of people that go to Starbucks every day that hate that they go to Starbucks every day.
Yeah.
Because of their politics.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right?
That's real.
So, yeah.
That's awesome. Andy, our third and final question for you. This one might be a little deeper for you, but I'd like to see your answer on this. Andy, what is a skill, okay, that you personally deem as toxic that other people see as good?
I don't know. Like what? Like a skill.
Yeah, a skill or a trait. Like other people are like, oh man, I fucking love Steve does this, and you're looking at like, eh.
Well, I don't know, dude. Like, you know, I think toxic's kind of a weak ass fucking word. I think it's overused. I think people that use it are weak. I think it's a buzz term that people use for shit they don't like. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I just think it's like, I think it's bullshit. Like, if you don't like something, move on. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
It's that simple. And I feel like everything is now, you know, if you don't like it, it's toxic. If you fight with your boyfriend, they're toxic. If you fight with your girlfriend, you're toxic. Motherfucker, fighting's a normal part of any relationship.
Yeah.
Stupid ass. Like, I just, dude, honestly, no filter, real talk, people are pussies. That's it. And it's top to bottom. It's left to right. It's across the board. We've been fed shitty food. We've been given stupid entertainment. We've been programmed with fucking mediocrity for the last 20 years. We've been told it's okay to be fat. We've been told it's okay to be lazy. It's okay to be whatever the fuck you are. And then people make up these things that they are. You know, it's fucking bullshit.
That's toxic. Yeah.
The whole social construct that they've been feeding us for 20 years now, 25 years. See, I'm old enough to know what it was like before that. That's right. The difference. A lot of these people listening, this is all they've known. They don't know what it was like to grow up, you know, beating the shit out of each other, even into adulthood, and then shaking hands and having a beer afterward.
Right.
They don't understand that concept. And our society is now, you know, it's like we talked about with fucking Rob and Dakota. It's professional victimhood all the time. You know, and I've talked about this for years and years and years. People compete over how big a victim they can be. They use words like toxic. They fucking throw these buzzwords around. When in reality, dude, not everybody's going to be for you. Not everything is going to be for you. How about you just identify what the fuck is and isn't for you and move the fuck on, you know, and stop making it about toxic trauma, this and that. Like, bro, people are just soft and that's it, you know, and that's coming from someone who's had real fucking trauma. Okay. None of you motherfuckers out there listening got stabbed in the fucking face. Okay. Like, you never had that.
Right.
Like, and most of the people that had that would have folded. Just, they would have used their whole life. Oh yeah, it was going to be great until I got stabbed in the face.
Right.
The real trick is making the shit that fucking happens to you work in your favor. That's the trick.
Yeah.
You know, God gives us all these hardships to overcome, to be part of our fucking story so that we can inspire other people to win too. And when you subscribe to the professional victimhood that everybody subscribes to these days, not only are you hurting yourself, you're hurting everybody around you. You're hurting your kids. You're hurting your potential in life. You're hurting your family. You're hurting your friends. You're hurting your neighbors, because what they see is just another example of someone who got dealt a bad hand that has decided to fucking fold. And that makes them think that it's okay. And it spreads. It's like fucking cancer. And until we in America stop being fucking soft ass little delicate pussies, we're going to continue to fucking fail, and that's it. So I don't really know. Like, I don't look at other people and say, oh, that skill is very toxic. I look at people who ask questions like that and think you're a fucking pussy.
Mm.
So that's my answer. And whoever wrote it ain't going to like it. It's just the truth. Like, why are you worried about somebody's toxicity skill?
Yeah.
You know, like, bro, I get told my beard is toxic. I get told my voice is toxic. I get told I'm toxic. You know what? Fuck off with that. Go surround yourself with people who lose. I win consistently at fucking almost everything I do. In fact, the only reason I say almost is because I'm maybe forgetting something, but all I could think about in my life are fucking wins. That's all I think about. I think about fucking winning and doing better and making a better impact. And I don't care if someone's got quote unquote toxic traits. Like, I just don't fuck with those people.
Yeah.
Like, what the fuck are people even worried about? Like, you guys don't even worry. Listen, here's the truth. I always say 8% of people are entrepreneurs, 1% are successful. I think over the next 20 years, that 1% is going to turn into 1/100th of that 1%, because what I see in the youth right now is a bunch of weak ass pussy shit. And I can tell you right now, you just don't have what the fuck it takes to make it. You better get tough. You better develop some grit. You better develop thick skin. You better be able to take a fucking insult. You better be able to handle people coming at you every motherfucking day, calling you names. You better be able to handle whole Instagram pages with accounts of tens of thousands of followers that fucking hate you. I deal with that every day. Okay? You motherfuckers can't handle someone calling you fucking toxic. So think about that.
That's real.
I know it's fucking real.
That's real. Yeah. Well, guys, Andy, that is three. So go pay the fee.
Yeah. Do that.
Sleeping on the floor, now my jewelry box froze. Fuck a bowl, fuck a stove, counted millions in a cold. Bad bitch, booted swole, got her on bankroll. Can't fold, just a no, head shot, case closed.